Hi, and welcome to another episode of the WAPI's IoT Lab. About 5 years ago, I posted a framework on Twitter, how to get started with digital services in the IoT space. Now, let's check how well it is still today and how it changed. Let's get into it. So about 5 years ago, I posted this message on Twitter, and it contains a framework for building blocks, how to create a smart service or product. Now, this framework, I still believe it's valid today, and I would like to walk you through it. So the first thing that we have here is actually the installed base. So you actually have the asset information, so what type of product it is. You have the customer information, so who owns it, and you have the location information. Those are very important blocks to have to build actually like all your services on top. So this is the first thing you need. The second thing you need is actually data. So connecting it to the internet, making it smart, collecting real-time information, and then having the data to actually create all these kind of new services. So the third step is actually to utilize the environment knowledge that you have accumulated. So how does it perform in a cold, hot environment, in a cold environment, and how can that be utilized to derive even further services out of it. The fourth step is actually optimization. So thinking about how can that asset perform better in a given environment. So for that, typically you would run continuous innovation or improvement processes and then can get started afterwards as a fifth step with a value chain optimization. So the value chain meaning like it's upstream and downstream. So, you know, how does the asset actually get on site and how is the customer utilizing it? Meaning you can optimize or cut out the middleman in between in some stages, or you can gain better customer understanding to actually know what the customer ultimately is after. So, and as a sixth step, we talk about value adds. So creating actually new disruptive concepts. So, and that is actually like a lot kind of like towards new type of revenue streams, cost savings or hygiene factors like health and safety. Those are things, you know, if they are not there, you might not be in business after a while. So very important blocks. And I would really like to stress that it's very, very important to have all these blocks in place. And then you can think about as a seventh step, actually, to consider performance-based services. So performance-based services are those services that you offer, for example, by not selling a product, but actually renting it. And while you rent it, you understand the customer environment better. And with basically like optimizing the operational performance, you're actually saving on your cost. But as your kind of like rental agreement has a fixed fee, you're actually generating profit. So operating an asset more efficiently. Now, that being said, so all of these things, they are typically utilizing the information that you have. So a certain product and asset that is actually being used to create a new type of business model. Now, I would call this actually the intranet of things. So obviously, we support all of that, being an intranet of things. But I would actually like to go even one step further, and that is actually the aggregation of services. So once you actually connect external services and products together, so you hook up on top off, for example, let's say external weather data, you connect to stock market information, you create a portal. We see a lot of companies creating their own IoT services. So actually, this is actually like connecting many IoT services together in a way, or Internet of Things services, as I would like to call them. And then you can actually derive really new type of things. And I think all these blocks, you know, you need to do them step by step to actually be really successful. It's like building a house. And if you don't have the foundation in place, or you don't have those elements in place, it is very hard to actually make it successful. So what do we see as a change from that framework, which I really still think it's applicable and many companies are after it? Actually, we see a lot of companies aiming straight for the crown jewel, the performance-based services. But what's different in nowadays world, it's actually, you know, when we look at that picture, you know, we're talking about connectivity, but then it's actually also about predicting things, about becoming much more cognitive. So actually using the data that is coming in, not just to visualize and to use analytics and AI models to predict and prevent, but also then to create actually a digital feedback loop so that you can start optimizing and automating. So actually creating really a smart product and service that is kind of like behaving by itself. So this really ultimately results in autonomous behavior. So really becoming an intelligent cognitive service that allows you to become like really on top of the game. Now, with all that being said, so what we see is, you know, having the tool suite in place with IoT Ticket to allow you to do all that. So we love to guide you along that journey. And if you have any questions, really feel free to get in touch with us. We're more than happy to help and consult on that topic. We have the frameworks in place. We have the expertise. We have the product. We can jumpstart you in the digital age, not tomorrow, but actually today.